concrete versus wood. Which one gives you more strength per dollar? As material prices fluctuate, it's important to think about what gives you the most bang for your buck. Let's look at a simple beam first. Take a 2x12 spanning 10 feet. With this, we can support about 1,200 pounds before failure, and this would cost about $33. Assuming number 2 grade or better, and exterior use pressure treated wood for a better comparison to the weatherability of concrete. Now, what if this 2x12 beam was concrete instead? Well, pure concrete achieves less than 10% the strength of reinforced concrete, so we would only be able to take about 130 pounds this way. So, let's add a rebar. Now we can take 2,300 pounds before failure, more than 10x the load with just one number 3 bar added. And this would only cost about $31. Assuming 4,000 PSI at 28 days, and just the one number 3 bar. Of course, it's unusual to have a 2x12 concrete beam, but the logic here extends to multiple widths. For example, the comparison is the same for a built-up 3-ply 2x12 and a similar size concrete beam. Note that self-weight, material resistance factors, and size effect factors have been considered here, and the prices are based on USA Northwest pricing for material only. These assumptions are consistent throughout the video. Let's catalog these strength per cost values and compare them to a few more scenarios to see which material is best. Let's compare a 2x4 wood frame deck to a 4-inch concrete slab. Both cases will assume sufficient compaction of the substrate. For the wood deck, we'll assume it's supported on posts and add up costs for the joists, nails, hangers, and some plywood on top. This comes out to about $350, and would be able to support about 4,000 pounds distributed. For the slab, we'll start by assuming it's placed directly on grade with a soil bearing stress of 25 kPa, which is on the low side of normal for compacted ground. Since the concrete is placed directly on grade, and concrete is much stronger than soil, the strength of the slab on grade will be equal to the soil strength below. This means that the concrete deck would be able to take a distributed load of nearly 50,000 pounds, and the cost for this comes in a little over $600. Note that reinforcing is not needed for strength in this case, but a few bars should be included anyways to help control shrinkage and cracking over weather cycles. In this case, the concrete wins again and by a much larger margin, and this is without saying anything about the long-term durability of these materials being exposed to the elements. However, this is not strictly a comparison of wood versus concrete in strength per price, because in this case the soil strength is governing over the concrete strength. The comparison does highlight the versatility of concrete though, because it's easily formable, generally inert, and has high compressive strength, which allows the slab to have strength equal to the soil in this case. Let's try a more direct comparison too, by checking a suspended deck. For a 4-inch concrete suspended slab, we'll need some formwork, which would be similar to the wood deck we just priced, and we'll need some structural reinforcing bars too. Adding all these prices up comes out to about $1,000, and in this case, the slab can support about 16,000 pounds. In terms of strength per dollar, this is a little closer to the wood deck than the concrete beam was to the wood beam, but concrete is still winning. How about comparing a wood column to a concrete column? For a 6x6 wood post 10 feet long, this would run about $58 and be able to carry about 20,000 pounds. For a concrete column with the same dimensions, the cost would be about $200, and the strength would be about 110,000 pounds. Adding this to our strength per cost table, we can see that both materials are more cost effective in taking compression load than they were in bending as beams, but concrete is still winning. So, to summarize, and list a few other relevant factors. Concrete comes out on top in the scenarios analyzed here, but there are a few important criteria to note. The prices here are for material only, and the labor costs for wood and concrete systems will vary. Labor cost is a significant factor for pricing construction work and can be difficult to estimate. However, we can do a sensitivity analysis on our numbers to see how labor price may affect the results. Even if we say labor for wood framing is zero, and the labor for concrete is 3 times the material cost, concrete still comes out on top in some of the cases we analyzed simply due to having much greater strength than wood. Another important factor is the grade of wood. We can buy $5 stud grade interior rated 2x4s, but they'll only allow stresses of 5 MPa. Spending $10 instead for a number 2 structural grade exterior rated piece would allow 10 MPa stress. Twice the cost, but also twice the strength. So this would not change our results one way or another, since we account equally for both strength and price. Scalability is also an important aspect of strength and cost analyses. For example, our 2x12 concrete beam can be scaled in width and depth to get an exponential increase in strength with a fairly linear increase in price. However, the same beam in wood can only be increased in width by adding plies. If additional depth is required, a different material such as glulam or other engineered lumber would be needed, which would result in an exponential increase in cost. A final point in favor of wood construction is general workability. Wood can be much easier to work with since it's fairly soft and light compared to concrete and comes in standard sizes ready to fasten and frame. In comparison, sure, you can get more strength per cost out of concrete, but it's also more labor-intensive to place and much more difficult to move or modify afterwards, if not impossible. Analyzing structural materials to take your dollar further can be complicated, and what's best can be very situational. In contrast, the best bang for your buck is completely clear when it comes to cybersecurity. The suite of services offered by NordVPN for you to have secure and private access to your internet is top tier. Nord offers the fastest VPN connection as well as threat protection against malicious websites, malware, trackers, and intrusive ads, even if you aren't connected to a VPN server. Nord's services allow you to secure up to 6 devices with a single account, securely manage your passwords, and keep your files protected with a private cloud. We've teamed up with Nord to offer you this exclusive deal for 4 months free on a 2-year cybersecurity package. Visit nordvpn.com/theenginehub to access this deal. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to hearing from you in the comments. See you next time.